Good morning to you all, dear students of class 7. Today once again I am here to take your as usual class. Now I am going to teach you a very interesting poem, and the topic of the poem is In the Bazaars of Hyderabad. This poem has been written by Sarojini Naidu. I hope you have heard the name Sarojini Naidu. She was born in 1879 and finally she died in 1949. So her contribution is very much in the field of literature. Here we not only come to read her poetries, writings, stories, but also she had actively taken part in the past in the freedom struggle of our country when the Britishers were there in our country to rule. I think you all know it very well. For her contribution, for her hard work, for her dedication in the field of literature, she was also given an honor. She was also given an honor, a kind of title she was provided with, and the title was given to her was the Nightingale of India. She was called as the Nightingale of India. I hope you all know it very well. So here in this particular poem, In the Bazaars of Hyderabad, what she has tried to do is, she has tried to draw the attention of the readers that when we go to a market, here she likes to call market in a common language as bazaar. Whenever a person goes or visits an Indian market, which she likes to call as bazaar, as I have already told you, what are the various things, those which the people are attracted towards to it? The markets are so colorful. The markets are rich with varieties of the things. Our country's tradition, culture, it is so rich. There are so many things, the colorful things are available in the market, because of which the people are attracted towards to it very much. Not only that, the merchants, those who are in the markets, what type of activities that they perform, what type of trade cries they do make in order to draw the attention of the customers, how do they behave, react, communicate with the various people, those who are coming in the bazaar, and how do the people, those who go to the bazaar, they notice so much things, the rich things which are available in the bazaars, that make them to feel really very happy and satisfied. All these things that the poetess here has tried her level best to present us, to for us to read, so that we can read, understand, and also at the same time enjoy those things which are available in the various places in the bazaars of our country. Especially she has drawn the attention of the bazaar of one of the bazaars of Hyderabad, children. So this is what we are going to learn in the entire poem of this particular chapter. I hope you will be really enjoying it later on when I'll explain it verse by verse and line by line. So please remain attentive. So here I am going to read out the lines for you, children. Listen it carefully. The topic, In the Bazaars of Hyderabad. What do you sell, O merchants? Richly your wares are displayed, turbans of crimson and silver, tunics of purple brocade, mirror with panels of amber, daggers with handles of jade. What do you weigh, O vendors? Saffron and lentil and rice. What do you grind, O maidens? Sandalwood, henna and spice. What do you call, O peddlers? Chessmen and ivory dice. What do you make, O goldsmiths? Wristlet and anklet and ring, bells for the feet of blue pigeons, frails as a dragonfly's wing, girdles of gold for the dancers, scabbards of gold for the king. What do you cry, O fruitsmen? Citron, pomegranate and plum. What do you play, O musician? Sitar, sarangi and drum. What do you chant, O magicians, spells for the aeons to come. What do you weave, O flower girls, with tassels of azure and red? Crowns for the brow of a bridegroom, chaplets to garland his bed, seeds of white blossoms, new garnered to perfume the sleep of the dead. Now I am going to explain the entire poem for you children. Before that, let me tell you, in this poem, Sarojini Naidu describes the colors and sounds of the various stalls in the bazaars of Hyderabad, the city where she was born and spent her childhood. So here I begin with the very first stanza. What do you sell, O merchants? The speaker wants to ask the merchants what you are all selling. Ye means you. Richly your wares are displayed, so decoratively, so attractively your things are spreaded in front of your shop. What you are all selling? This is how the speaker asks. And what does that particular merchant to whom the question was asked replies? He replies, turbans of crimson and silver. I am selling the turbans which is in crimson and silver color. Tunics of purple brocade. I am selling the tunics which is purple brocade. Brocade here it means a thick heavy fabric with a raised pattern woven specially for gold or silver silk threads. Such type of things that I am selling, tunics of purple brocade. Mirror with panels of amber. I am also selling the different types of mirrors which frames are made of amber, and daggers with handles of jade. And I am too selling the daggers. Daggers means weapon, no? A kind of sharp knife. Those daggers I am selling, which handles are made of jade. Jade is a kind of special stone. Usually it is used to make the precious ornaments and jewelries, you know. Such type of things, the commodities that at the moment I am selling here all. This is how the merchant replies to the speaker when such a question was asked to him. Now coming to the second verse of the poem. Again, the speaker happens to visit another shop and happens to ask the similar type of question here too. What do you weigh, O vendors? This time the speaker happens to ask a vendor. The vendor was at that moment busy to weigh something, to measure something. Then what does the vendor reply in it? Saffron and lentil and rice. The vendor replies, I am selling the various things like saffron, lentil, rice, the food materials, you know, eatable things that he was selling at that time. So that is how the shopkeeper replies, the vendor replies. What do you grind, O maidens? Once again, the speaker happens to ask the similar question to such certain maidens. The maidens might be at that time were very busy to grind something, okay? So the maidens happen to reply here, sandalwood, henna and spice. We are all grinding sandalwood, henna and different types of spices. This is how the maidens to reply to the speaker. What do you call, O peddlers? Jasmine and ivory dyes. So in this way, the various shops, the various vendors, places the speaker visits and happens to ask the different type of questions, because the speaker is very delightful, very delighted, excited to visit the different shops and the vendors' shops, because all the shops, all the vendors' shops which were there in the bazaar of Hyderabad were so attractive, so colorful that she could not ignore a single shop. Each and every shop were so beautiful, so colorful that she liked to visit each and everywhere and liked to ask something to them about the various type of commodities that they were selling at that time. Now we move on to the third stanza, children. What do you make, O goldsmiths? This time the speaker happens to visit a goldsmith's shop and happens to ask the similar question, what you are all making, my dear goldsmith? Then the goldsmith happens to reply here, wristlet and anklet and ring. I am here busy
to make the different types of wristlet. Wristlet means a kind of ornament usually used to wear in the wrist. And anklet, it is also a kind of ornament usually girls are found to be wearing into their ankles, you know. So, and also I am busy to make the rings. In this way, the various type of ornaments that the goldsmith was busy to make, bracelet, anklet, rings, that is how he replies to the speaker that I am busy to make all these different types of ornaments. Bells for the feet of blue pigeons. I am also busy here to make small type of bells which can be fitted into the small feet of the pigeons. Frail as a dragonfly's wing. And what type of bells that the goldsmith was making for the feet of the pigeons? Very, very thin, very weak and thin type of bells that it would be fitted into the feet of the pigeons. Such type of bells that he was busy to make for the pigeons especially. Frail as a dragonfly's wing. Dragonfly's wing, I think you have noticed. So feeble look it look, no? So thin it look. Similar type of bells that the goldsmith was busy to make at that moment. That is how he replies to it too. Girdles of gold for the dancers. And he was also busy to make girdles for the dancers, which was made of gold. What do you mean by girdles here? Girdles here means a kind of belt or thick strings fastened around the waist to keep the clothes in position. A kind of belt, you can say, made of metal, you know. So here the goldsmith was busy to make such type of girdles for the dancers, which was made of gold, right? So this is the thing that he explains to the speaker. Scabbards of gold for the king. And he was also busy to make scabbards, meaning of scabbards, covers for swords made of leather or metal. Cover of the swords. Sometimes it is made of metal, sometimes it is made of leather. So such type of things that the goldsmith was very busy to make for different people. So this is how the goldsmith also tells to the speaker that how he was so much busy to make the varieties of the things for the different people. Next, stanza 4. What do you cry, O a fruitsman? This time the speaker happens to visit a fruitsman's shop, okay? And at that moment the fruitsman was making his trade cry. What do you mean by trade cry here? Trade cry means a kind of sound the shopkeepers sometimes they make. The vegetable sellers, maybe fruit sellers, maybe ice cream seller, whatever. It is found there in the market square. Sometime in order to draw the attention of the customers, they make loud sounds so that customer will listen to them and come to buy goods from them. Such type of cries are called as trade cries, okay? Here, the fruitman was also making similar type of trade cry. That is why the speaker happened to ask to him, "What do you cry, my dear fruitman?" Then the fruitman replies, "Citron." Citron here it means, citron means citrus fruits. Citrus fruits, the fruits which have full of juice in it, showery in taste, you know, such fruits are citrus fruits. So I am calling out citron, pomegranate, plum, these are things that I am selling here. That is why I am calling out all these in order to sell to my customer. This is how the fruitman happened to reply to the speaker. What do you play, O musician? This time again the speaker happens to visit a musician's place and happens to ask to him, what do you play, what you are playing with, what type of music instrument you are playing. This is what the speaker happens to ask, and the musician happens to reply, sitar, sarangi and drums. These are all the musical instruments that I am playing at the moment, says the musician. What do you chant, O magician? Very next to that, the speaker happens to visit a magician's place. There also similar question, what do you want, what do you do, and what do you make a chant? Chanting means kind of a muttering sound which is made, no? Such type of sounds are called chant, okay? So what you are chanting, my dear magician? And then spells for the aeons to come. I am making such a chant so that aeons will come. Aeons means, here the meaning of eons is an extremely long period of time. Okay, this is how the magician also give the reply. In this way, we finally move on to the last stanza of the poem Children. So here I explain you the last stanza. What do you weep, O flower girls? This time the speaker happens to visit to the flower girls. Those were found to be very busy to make various kind of objects with the help of flowers, you know. And that is how now the here speaker visits and asks, what you are all doing, what you are all making and weaving with tassels of azure and red. Tassels means a bunch of threads that are tied together at one end and hang from cushions, curtains, clothes, etc. as a decoration. So the girls were found to be using those tassels, very beautiful, colorful threads of azure and red in color. Azure is a bright blue color. So these were found, the girls were found to be using all these beautiful threads, which were in bright blue in color and red in color, and they were making beautiful flowers, garlands with the help of all these. Okay, crowns for the brow of a bridegroom. And they tell, the girls tell, that they were busy to make crowns for the bridegroom, beautiful crowns for the bridegroom. That is what it made them to use those tassels of azure and red, those beautiful threads of azure in color and red in color, bright blue in color and red in color. Chaplets to garland his bed. Chaplets here, it means strings of flowers. They were also found to be busy to make the strings of flowers so that they could decorate the bed of the bridegroom. The garlands, with the help of those garlands made of chaplets, they could decorate the bed of the bridegroom. This is what they were all found to be, very busy with their flowers, with their colorful threads. That is what they tell and explain to the speaker. Seeds of white blossoms new garnered. And they were also found to be making seeds of the white flowers. They were also found to be making the seeds of the white flowers. Garnered here, it means new. Garnered here, it means newly obtained or collected. Those fresh and newly flowers, white flowers, which were collected, which were found, with the help of that, they were busy to make the seeds. Okay? Of white blossoms, they were making seeds of white blossoms to perfume the sleep of the dead. And with this particular flowers which they had collected, white flowers, white blossoms that they had, newly fresh white blossoms that they had collected, where they wanted to place it all this for? They wanted to place all these garlands to the sleep of the dead, the burial places of the dead, that they wanted to place it so that its fragrance, so the fragrance of the flower can be spreaded all around the graves of the dead people. So this is a very responsible duty that these girls were doing at that moment, that they explained to the speaker children. In this way, we come to the end of the entire poem, the explanation of the entire poem.